If you're trying to feel the same old holes inside, there's a better life. Oh, there's a better life. If you got pain, he's a pain
taker. How are you enjoying yourself so far? You're blessed, yeah?
Yeah.
This lovely new home.
Exactly. After baptism, she received the Holy Ghost at all. He says, no matter what the Holy Ghost, she went in heaven, started praying, and she received the Holy Ghost. So it can happen to you also, even today.
Amen.
I would like Brother Jordan to tell them also how he repented and made right. Oh, you want to confess them, talk to them, the four of them want to be baptized.
Who's being baptized and put your hand up? Four people. Yeah? I'm going to tell you how lucky you are to be baptized at this young age.
Amen.
Me?
When I was a little boy, I didn't know about God. Like, I didn't believe in God, and I didn't have an opportunity to get to know Jesus. I never picked a Bible up, you know. And as I grew older, I made wrong choices. I made choices to be violent, fighting at school. I got kicked out of school. And then I started being nasty to people I loved and cared about, like my mum, my dad. These people brought me up into this world and I was disrespecting them. I thought that in my world I could do what I wanted, nobody could tell me any different. I started selling drugs, I started robbing people and doing things that I just thought it were free gain. I could do whatever I wanted. Then I had a little boy when I was 21, then my life changed. Then I realised that what my mum had gone through, what I'd put my parent through. And then I still didn't change when I had my little boy. When I was in your mum and dad situation, I still didn't change. I still didn't come to God. Then I went to prison for nearly killing somebody. I beat them up really, really bad. And I went to jail. And when I was in jail, I lost everything I'd ever had. God took everything from me. I mean, my friends, my mum, my son, everything I got, God took. And when I didn't want to live anymore, when I didn't want to be here anymore, God saved me. Like, he told me, I'd never picked a Bible up, never gone to church, didn't believe in God, and I heard a voice in my head, and it was God saying, pick that Bible up. And from me picking that Bible up, was the best choice of my life. Because I met my brothers, who are we now, I met Pastor John, an amazing man who baptised me, and then when I got baptised, that was when I realised how unlucky I were. Because I'd had to wait 30 years. And you have got this opportunity now where we're a good family, good friends, and we're getting baptised and making this decision. God honours it. You doing this now, I know you don't understand it, but I promise you, God honours it. So take this moment you've got now and run with the rest of your life. Don't make the mistakes I did, because even if you do, God's not going to let you go. He can't. You child of God wants you to make that decision. So like Brother Chris says, once you've been baptized, keep your eyes on the kingdom, keep your eyes on God, and he will bless you for the rest of your life and your family. God bless you.
Amen.
Amen.
The Bible says in Acts chapter 2:37, when the gospel was preached on that day, by Peter, they said, what shall we do to be saved? And they were pricked in their hearts. They wanted to do something. They were convinced that Jesus Christ died and rose again.
Amen.
And that eternal life was only through Jesus Christ. And when they were convinced, they said, what shall we do? From our conviction, what shall we do? It says, repent of your sins. And the Bible says you must repent. Those who want to be baptized, you must repent.
Amen.
I know you are all young people. You may not have done a lot of bad things, but I want you to look in your lives. From the time you would remember back when you did something wrong, which is contrary to the word of God. If you have a piece of paper or pen, I would like you to write down so that you won't forget. If you got a piece of paper or in a pen somewhere, I want you to write down what you think you sinned against God. Write it with your own hands. What you want to ask God to forgive you. To write down. This might be a new thing, you may never have done it. But it makes you realize. It makes you realize what you have done and what you are saying before God. You are committing to writing also. So you won't write anything wrong. You write exactly what you've done wrong, and you want God to forgive you. So if you want God to forgive you something, I want you to write it down right now. And then you can meet the pastor there and speak to him if you want. Then you can read from your script what you've written down, what you know you've done wrong, and you want God to forgive you. Repentance, when you do it properly, when you repent of all your sins, God will forgive you. The Bible says in John 1 verse 12, to them that he received him, he gave them power to become the children of God. So today you can receive power to become a child of God. If you repent your sins thoroughly, I'm telling you, it happened to me. On the 8th of August, 1981, I made my life public. I was only 22, 23 years of age. I repented of my sins. And I tried to go back as far back as I could. I was thinking about it from the time I decided to baptize. What am I going to repent? I want to clean my life. I want to start afresh. Amen. What I've done wrong, I want to start a new walk to become a new creature in Jesus Christ. I didn't write down, but I tried to dig back from when I was 9 years, when I was stealing sugar, stealing groundnuts from my mother, disobeying sometimes, stealing money. If I see mama, leave some change on the table, take it, go buy sweets. I began to write it down.
That's right.
Until I was at that age of 23. And I remembered repenting. When I went to the man who wanted to be, yeah, maybe we can go talk to them also. Amen. Amen. So you make it right. And when you do that correctly, and you ask God to forgive you, God has no favor. God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. When you do it correctly and from your heart, and God sees your heart, whether you mean it or not, when you mean it from the bottom of your heart, God will know that you have meant it and you have said it. And if you forget anything, he will remind you to repent that one as well. And when you do that and you confess that you don't want it anymore, from now on you want to start a new walk with the Lord, God will respect that. And God will forgive you of all those things you have done wrong. And when you take him in baptism, in the name of Jesus Christ, your sins will be taken away from you from that moment. God will not remember it because you have confessed it. The Bible says if you hide your sin, you will not obtain mercy. If you try to hide your wrongdoings, if you try to hide what you have done wrong and you want to cover it up, you won't have mercy. But when you come openly and repent every sin, God will give you mercy. The scripture says then in Proverbs, who hides these sins will not prosper. But he who repents and confession, the prophet says, is good for the soul. When you repent, God will see your meaning from the bottom of your heart, and you don't want it, and you step into water baptism and repent thoroughly, God will give you the Holy Ghost. Amen. I remember when I went into the water myself, I was young, 23 years old, but I was still young, not very mature. But I repented everything I knew, and I told the minister, made right, and I went into the water and said, have you forgotten anything else? I thought, I said, Pastor, I think I've done it. That was Brother Maxwell. I said, Pastor, I think I've thoroughly repented. And when I did that, and when he baptized me in the water, I really felt a burden taken off of my life. I felt like I was carrying a heavy load, invisible. Amen. Evil spirits that was following me all my life, yes, or that I was carrying unawares, iniquities, habits which were wrong, which was in me. And it was literally like taken away from me. Hallelujah. And I went back home light. I was like walking on air. I was like walking in the sky, walking in air. Because something was taken off from me. Then I went home. I listened to a tape. It became a start to fulfill all righteousness. Brother, sister, I lied. The Holy Ghost came upon me that very night. The same day on the 8th of August, 1981. And I want to say all the sins that I confessed that day. The sins I confessed that day. Of course, they didn't have any more power on me. I used to drink. I used to smoke. I used to do wrong things. But those things, the power of God came and broke it from me. When they were taken away from me, they did come back. And I'm speaking 40 years later. This is over 40 years on the 8th of August, 81. The smoke I used to smoke, I smoke no more. The drink I used to drink, I drink no more. The bad habits I had, they vanished. Because of why? I repented and followed the instruction of God. Amen. This is an institution. This is one of the things God told us to do. Whoever accepts and believes must be baptized. They must repent of their sins and be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ correctly, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, for the remission of their sins, and God will remit those sins. And he'll give you also power to overcome. And when that power is given to you, it's yours. You can claim. Satan can come with this. You address Satan every day because you are reading the word of God. When he comes, blessed Satan, get away. You address Satan all the time. When he comes, you try to last to say, hey, Satan, I'm a Christian. I'm a married man. And he goes, he understands. He tries. It doesn't mean Satan won't try. He will try you. But you have got power in him. You have got a hidden power. As a Christian, every Christian has got a hidden power in him. That comes from God invisible when you make the right choice. When you have made the right choice with your whole heart, God sees your heart. When you mean it from your heart, he will understand. He will know it. This man, he means it, and God also means business with you. He will give you the power to become a Christian. From that day, myself, I started walking the Lord, started enjoying the Bible, reading the Bible. Now I've got ammunition. If the devil comes with any temptation or trial, I fire back with the scripture. When the devil comes with any scripture, any temptation, I fire back with the quotation. And that's what we must do. That's the way the Christian must read the Bible every day. Listen to the text of the prophet. You are being equipped when Satan comes. In any way, you fire back with the word of God. You fire a missile with the scripture.
Yes, sir.
You fire a missile, a ballistic missile of scripture, of quotations of the prophet. And that's how we overcome. You realize Satan when he comes. In any story, sorry, my dear son, my dear great. Sorry. So you fire back with the scripture. You fire back with the word of God. And that's how you overcome as a Christian. You have repented of your sins. And when Satan comes back in any way, you fire back to him with the scripture. That's how Jesus did. He showed us how to defeat Satan. When he says, fall down, you will be the angels who the scripture says will not dash your feet against it. Says, Satan, thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. And that's what we must do when evil spirits come with suggestions. When Satan comes in any way attacking you with the suggestion, you fire back with the word of God. And he understands the word of God is power to defeat Satan anywhere. As any circumstance, under any condition.
Yes, sir.
Amen. He will defeat Satan. Any condition, under any circumstance. Amen. Satan will be defeated by the word of God. We must use the word of God to fight Satan.
Amen.
We must use the scriptures and the quotations of the prophet.
Yes.
The prophet preaches and clears us in the message of the hour. So you use those quotations. When God speaks you through the quotations, you use those to fight God. I like this. Whenever I listen to a tape in the morning, there are a few quotations, maybe one or two statements that stays with me. Or a scripture, and I use that for the day. When Satan comes, I use those quickened scriptures or quickened quotations. I use them to fight Satan. And I will overcome him.
Hallelujah.
Because I have some special...